Hi everyone, my name is AD and welcome back to Art Spot Online, the online version of our weekly free drop-in art making program for children and families at the Tampa Museum of Art. Today we're going to learn a little bit about the work of Mernet Larsen and create a fun hanging sculpture inspired by her painting Raft. Mernet Larsen is an artist who has been active since the 1970s and professor emeritus at the University of South Florida. She currently lives in Tampa and in Jackson Heights, New York. Larsen is known for her geometric figures and landscapes that are responding to paintings from art history. Her art history inspirations include art from the Italian Renaissance, abstract geometric art from Russia, Japanese hand scrolls, and French painter Paul Cézanne. Larsen based her painting Raft on collections of geometric shapes that she found in paintings by early 20th century Russian artists like Ella Sitsky and Kazimir Malevich. She then used those shapes to depict a swimmer and a fisherman, people who you would not be surprised to see in the Tampa Bay area. Unexpected and interesting things happen, though, when you depict these ordinary, organic things with only geometric shapes. The shapes that make up the objects and people in this painting are clear and precise, but how those shapes interact, where they're located in this geometric space, those things become less clear and more surprising the longer that you look at it. So for example, are those dark diamond shapes holes in a gray surface, or are they the bottoms of clouds that are floating in a gray sky, right? They could be either or. Are the figures surfing down this huge wave, or are we just looking at a very calm sea from this extreme angle? We know the horizon is far away, but when we noticed how the tip of the fisherman's head is resting perfectly on the horizon, what once felt very far away now feels unusually close to us. And notice how the raft is floating on the water. Is it floating perfectly flat on this still body of water, or is it at an angle with some of the raft kind of kicked up in the air like a skateboard? And how is a fisherman balancing on the raft anyway? Why do the parts of the raft that are farther away appear bigger than the parts of the raft that are closer to us? This is just scratching the surface of what you can see in this painting, and so many more questions can arise while looking at Raft. Something else we want to ponder for today's project is this. What do you think is underneath the surface of the water in this picture? So for this project, we're going to imagine what's beneath the surface and try to depict those things only using geometric shapes. We'll then use our undersea geometric objects to create a hanging sculpture. We're also going to reverse where we expect to see our undersea objects by hanging them from the ceiling. That way, our sculptures will be part of this same kind of backwards, upside-down world of Mernet Larsen's Raft. So all we're going to need today is some cardboard, construction paper, scissors, a hole punch, markers, glue stick, and string. If you don't have a hole punch, you can just use a chopstick or a sharp pencil. If you don't have any construction paper, you can just use regular paper and you can color with markers. So to get started, we're going to cut a piece of cardboard down into about a 9-inch square, and you're going to glue a piece of construction paper to the top of it. This is eventually going to represent the water, so you want to pick a color that reminds you of water. You can color it with markers if you're only using white paper, and if you don't have any cardboard around, you can just use an old paper plate too. Next, we want to draw a spiral made out of straight lines like I'm doing here, and then you just want to cut along that line. And now for the fun part, you want to imagine some things that might be under the surface of the water and draw your ideas on colored construction paper, trying to only use simple geometric shapes in your creation. So squares, circles, triangles, and rectangles. And just make sure you leave enough space to punch a hole through the top of each of your drawings. Next, you want to cut out your drawings and make sure you add details to the other side of your shape too, because these things are going to be hanging from a string and floating, so you're going to be able to see both sides. Next, use a hole punch or chopstick or sharp pencil at the top of each one to make a little hole, and you're going to use the same tool to make one hole in your cardboard spiral for each drawing that you've made. And then just get your string and tie each one to your cardboard spiral. Make sure you don't tie the knot really closely to the drawing. You can make kind of a little loop like this so you don't have to worry about the string tearing through your paper. The last step is to just create another hole, this time in the center of your cardboard spiral, and then tie a piece of string to that. You can then hang your creation from the ceiling or tie it to a long stick to represent a fishing pole, and your geometric fishing scene is complete. If you want a little bit of an extra challenge, and if you want to start constructing imagery in a way that's similar to how Mernet Larsen does, what you can do is you can cut out a lot of different geometric shapes of different colors and start to move them around until you begin to recognize images in those abstract structures, and then you can use those as the basis for the hanging parts of your sculpture. You can vary the size too. You can try to make one undersea object really, really big and one really, really small. That's Art Spot for this week. Thank you for learning and making with the Tampa Museum of Art. Remember to like this video and subscribe so you don't miss any new episodes, and I'll see you next week.